السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. إغاثة الملهوف أو إعانة الملهوف أو ذا الحاجة الملهوف من الكلمات التي ذكرت في بعض أحاديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، ومن الوصايا التي أوصى بها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. One of the ahadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned among the advice that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gives to the Muslim, and it is one of the main good manners of the Muslim, is called إغاثة ذا الحاجة الملهوف, to help and support the needy and the aggravated, the person who is in desperate need. Allah Azza wa Jal had tested us in this life along with the test of death. He had tested us with so many things. He had tested us with goodness and with evil. He had tested us with the difficulty, the hardship, and with the ease. He had also tested us with prosperity and adversity. He mentions this in the Quran, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ. We will test you with some of the fear and some of the hunger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says in the Quran, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. We will test you with evil and with good as a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to Allah azza wa jal you will return. When someone is being tested, this test that is being given to this person is not only for him. It is for him and for the other people at the same time. When someone is tested with sickness, illness, and disease, it's not only for him, is also for the healthy ones to go and visit him and make dua for him and raise and elevate his spirituality. If someone is tested with any problem, with any issue, with any crisis, with any hardship, it is also a test for the other people. On the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask those who were not directly tested about their help and their support of those who are being directly tested. مَرِضْتُ فَلَمْ تَعُدْنِي, Allah will say, I was sick and you did not visit me. How can I visit you? And you are the Lord of the worlds. My servant so and so was sick. Didn't he know that if you visited him, you will get the reward from me? I was hungry and you did not feed me. How can I feed you? And you are the Lord of the worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, didn't he know that my servant so and so was hungry and you did not feed him? Don't you know that if you had fed him, you will see this with me? ولذلك الرحمة بين البشر, the cooperation, the help that should be exchanged among the human beings, this kind of help and this kind of support has no limits, and it should not distinguish between even the ideologies and the religions and the races and the colors. As long as the person is in need, it is the obligation of everyone else to help this person and to support him. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن الله عز وجل قد أذهب عنكم عبية الجاهلية وفخرها بالآباء, مؤمن تقي أو كافر شقي فاجر شقي, أنتم بنو آدم وآدم من تراب, لا يدعن رجال فخرهم بأقوام, إنما هم فحم من فحم جهنم, أو لا يكونن أهون على الله عز وجل من الجعلان التي تدفع بأنفها أنة. The Prophet ﷺ said in his hadith, indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had taken away from you the pride of the ignorance period. And he had taken from you the boasting of your fathers and grandfathers. People are either a pious believer or a wicked disbeliever. All of you belong to Adam, and Adam was created from dust. Let some people set aside their boasting with their fathers and their forefathers. They are just the fuel from the fuel of Jahannam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are considered in the sight of Allah less than the ji'lan, the beetle, which pushes away the corpse and the bad things. Subhanallah, like the insects. So in this hadith, we see how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made it very clear that we all belong to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, and Adam is created from dust. He explains in this hadith how important for the people to be united when someone is in need, when someone needs help and support. That's why one of the main qualities of the Abrar, and the Abrar are considered as those that are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as in Surah Al-Insan, إِنَّ الْأَبْرَارَ يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْ كَأْسٍ كَانَ مِزَاجُهَا كَافُورًا. All the description of the drink, the food, the blessings, the pleasures that the Abrar, those pious and righteous ones, will get from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the Day of Judgment, Allah Azza wa Jal mentions one of their main qualities, يُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامِ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. One of their main qualities was, they used to feed the people. Although they might be in need of this food, they might be in desperate need, but they love what they give. They might be in love of this money they spend, but because they want to help those yateen, the orphans, those masakeen, the needy, those captives of war, Allah Azza wa Jal says, يُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. And what they say, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. We only feed you and we only give you, we only provide for you, we only support you for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. My dear brothers and sisters, there are many hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that talk about إِغَاثَةِ الْمَلْهُوفِ, meeting the need of the needy and the aggravated person. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول, من نفس عن مؤمن كربة من كرب الدنيا نفس الله عنه كربة من كرب يوم القيامة. ومن يسر على معسر يسر الله عليه في الدنيا والآخرة. ومن ستر مسلما ستره الله في الدنيا والآخرة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever relieves a believer from the difficulty and hardship, Allah Azza wa Jal will relieve him from the difficulty of hardship in this world and the hereafter. And whoever makes things easy for the Muslim, for the one who is in difficulty and in hardship, Allah will make things easy for him in this dunya and in the akhirah. And whoever conceals the faults and the mistakes of the other person, Allah Azza wa Jal will conceal his faults and his mistakes in this dunya and the akhirah. The reward, he is doing it in this dunya, but he will get the reward in this dunya and in the akhirah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as you know, mentioned in the hadith that the believers in their connection with each other, in their cooperation, in their mercy amongst each other, is like one body. When any part, just one tooth, when any limb, when any part of this body ails, the entire body will have a sleepless night. Same thing with the Muslim Ummah. When a part of this Ummah is suffering, we can see what is going on, and we can see, subhanallah, sometimes we have to turn the news off just not to see the destruction and the things that are going on. We are watching that. How about the people who are living there? Can you imagine with no food, with no water, with no basics of life? Subhanallah al-Azim. And the entire world seems to be like silent, as if nothing is happening, subhanAllah. Those innocent civilians, people are paying the price for nothing, subhanAllah Azza wa Jalla. Families have gone. And there are many people now that either they have someone who really passed away from the family, someone who is sick, someone who is already martyr, someone, subhanallah al-azim. That's why this description of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam is that the believers, the Muslims, are like one body. When any part of the body ails, the entire body should be awake, should be always vigilant, should be always paying attention to that. That should be the way that the Muslims are. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to unite all the Muslims and to get them back together in the right track, to be strong power, that they will be like the Ahd, the time, the generations of the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and their followers. Allahumma ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يمر على قوم وهم جلوس في الطريق فيقول إن كنتم لابد فاعلين فهدوا السبيل وردوا السلام وأغيثوا الملهوف. He passed by a group of people that were sitting like on the road, like talking and having conversation. He said to them, if you have to sit like this, then you have to do these things. Guide the people on their way. Answer the salam when someone says the salam to you. أَغِيثُ الْمَظْلُومِ, which means help the person who is the victim of injustice, and help the person who is really in need. You know, helping the one who is in need was one of the main qualities of the Prophet ﷺ, even before he became a prophet. We remember the story when he was in the cave of Hira receiving the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he came. The first time he received the revelation from Allah Azza wa Jal, he came as he was frightened and scared to Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إني خشيت لقد خشيت على نفسي. I was concerned about myself. If you look at the response of Khadija radiallahu ta'ala anha, what she said, كلا والله لا يخزيك الله أبدا. She said, no, by Allah, Allah will never fail you, will never frustrate you, will never disgrace you. Wallahi, and she justified this for him. Why Allah will never fail you? And this applies to every Muslim. Why Allah will never fail you as a Muslim? It is because of that. What did she say? قالت, Wallahi, إنك لا تصل الرحم وتحمل الكل وتكسب المعدوم وتقري الضيف وتعين على نوائب الحق. All these qualities she mentioned is helping the people who are in need. Keep the good and the kind relationship with the kith and the kin. You help the poor and the needy. You support the one who is in need of your advice. You are very generous to the guest. You help the people who are in hardship and in crises. She justified for the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that Allah would never disgrace him because of that. And this is one of the main qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So, one day, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sitting in the masjid, and a group of Mudar, a tribe from Arabia. These people, they were like kind of poor, and they came to the masjid. Only every one of them only had one dress, like just a blanket covering his body. And when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam looked at them, subhanallah al-azim, yani his face, it changed. Out of sadness, grief, concern about those people. Then he stood up and he addressed the people. He praised Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ تَقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ. O people, fear Allah who created you from a single person, till the end of the ayah. And he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا. Indeed, Allah is watching over you. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَلْتَنظُرْ نَفْسٌ مَّا قَدَّمَتْ لِغَدٍ. O believers, fear Allah and see what you have forwarded for yourself. And then he said to them, تصدق رجل من ديناره من درهمه من ثوبه من صاع بره من صاع تمره حتى قال ولو بشق تمرة. فجاء رجل من الأنصار بصرة كادت كفه تعجز عنها بل قد عجزت. ثم تتابع الناس يقول الراوي حتى رأيت كومين من طعام وثياب حتى رأيت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يتهلل بوجهه. فقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من سن سنة حسنة فله أجرها وأجر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة ومن سن سنة سيئة فعليه وزرها ووزر من عمل بها إلى يوم القيامة. When this group of people came and they were very poor. The Prophet ﷺ was concerned about them. Then he addressed the people, he talked to them, and he said to them, a man give any charity from his dinar, a man give any charity from his dirham, a man give any charity from his clothes, a man give any charity from his burr, from his wheat, a man give any charity from his dates. Even he said, even half a date. And then the narrator said, I see people bringing everything before the Prophet ﷺ, to the point that one of the Ansar was bringing a big container of like yani money in his hand, to the point that his hand cannot even hold it. And he put it in front of the Prophet ﷺ, and the Messenger of Allah ﷺ, seeing that, he got so happy about the help and the support of the people for this poor group of people. And then he said, whoever initiated, whoever revived a good sunnah in Islam will have the reward of this sunnah, and the one who is acting according to this sunnah until the day of judgment. And whoever initiated or revived a bad thing in Islam will have the punishment of that bad thing, and anyone who is acting according to this until the day of judgment. So my dear brothers and sisters, we know all these ahadith of the Prophet ﷺ. We have many ayat of the Quran. What can we do as Muslims? Just in 3 points. Number one, we should feel this kind of suffering and this kind of hardship and this kind of crisis and this kind of problem that our brothers and sisters in Gaza are going through. We should just at least in our hearts, we feel what they feel. We can imagine ourselves in their position and in their place and what is happening to them. And secondly, at least we should help them with any kind of means. Even if it is a small help, it's really great in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Allah azza wa jalla promises to multiply the reward for the one who is helping the poor, the needy, the distressed, the one who is in hardship and difficulty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. Thirdly, which everyone can do, even if he cannot help financially, at least pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah azza wa jal relieves them from this problem, from this crisis, from this unprecedented cleansing, this unprecedented destruction that never happened to anyone. Subhanallah, when you see the pictures, even from the satellite, and you see, like, subhanallah al-azim, complete areas have been demolished completely. Some of these houses just demolished on the heads of their people. Subhanallah, people are still under the wreckage. They cannot even get them out. This is something, at least, each one of us in the night time, before Fajr, wake up, pray two rak'ah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and in your tahajjud, in your sujood, make dua for them. Maybe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept. And Allah azza wa jalla promises in the Quran, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. نَسْأَلُ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى أَنْ يُلْهِمَ أَهْلَنَا إِخْوَتَنَا وَأَخَوَاتِنَا فِي غَزَّةَ الصَّبْرَ يَا رَبَّ الْعَالَمِينَ. اللهم إنا نسألك أن تعينهم على ما هم فيه. اللهم أعنهم وأيدهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم شهداءهم. اللهم ارحم شهداءهم. اللهم ارحم شهداءهم. اللهم اشف مرضاهم يا الله يا كريم. اللهم اشف مرضاهم يا الله يا كريم. اللهم كن معهم ولا تكن عليهم. اللهم إنك الأحد الصمد الملجأ إليهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنك تعلم أن كثيرين يخذلونهم فلا تخذلهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم إنهم جياع فأطعمهم وعراة فاكسهم يا الله يا كريم. اللهم رحمتك نرجو فلا تكلنا إلى أنفسنا طرفة عين ولا أقل من ذلك. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. اللهم انصر الإسلام وأعز المسلمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، استغفرك وأتوب إليك. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.